Bill.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
And you.
So, from the moment Robert Redford bought the rights, he seemed determined to cast himself as Bill Bryson. How did you feel about that? Do you think maybe the producers got something a little wrong in their decision-making?
Not the least bit. I was very, very, very pleased and honoured, for obvious reasons, that Robert Redford would want to take that on. And not just because, I mean, it's very flattering to have such a superstar portraying me on the big screen, but also there was a huge amount of comfort attached to the idea that Robert Redford was not just the principal actor in the movie, but the guiding creative force for the whole movie.
Okay.
And, you know, so I knew it was in safe hands. I knew that this movie was going to be... He only makes intelligent movies, so
yeah.
Whatever he did with it, I had every confidence that it would be something that I would be pleased to be associated with.
Why did you pick the Appalachian Trail?
Totally accidental, just a fluke, that in 1995, my wife, English wife, and I and our four kids moved to the States pretty impetuously,
mm-hmm.
And we settled in a town in New Hampshire, knew nothing about, and one day I was out for a walk, and I discovered that the Appalachian Trail ran right through this town that we just moved to. There was a signboard I found on the edge of town that said, you know, 400 miles north to Maine,
yeah.
to the northern terminus of the Appalachian Trail, and 1,800 miles or whatever it was south to Georgia. And there was the longest long-distance footpath in the world, but ran a block from our house.
Right.
And I just thought, I'll do that.
Yeah,
I'd like to do
exciting.
That, see how it goes.
And the subtitle of your book actually spoke about rediscovering America. Is that what you set out to do?
Yeah, it was. I thought I was going to do that. And what I found was that was completely wrong. Because there wasn't, you know, I'd grown up in America, and so I thought somehow I was going to reconnect with America. But this was a completely different experience from any that I'd ever had before.
Uh-huh.
It had nothing to do with any part of the United States I was familiar with and experienced with. This was a new world. This was wilderness world.
Right.
And so, no, I was finding a completely different world, a world that most people never experience at all.
Yeah.
Quite wonderful, but also really hard, very challenging.
Well, it looked absolutely gorgeous. And, I mean, did you find that your experience with the walk was similar to how the film presented it?
Yeah.
These beautiful shots of this gorgeous landscape.
Well, the one thing you don't get when you're on the ground on the Appalachian Trail a lot of the time is the great views. It's one of the things that a movie can bring you that you don't get, because, you know, the movie can bring in helicopter shots. They can step back,
yeah.
and you can see a whole panorama. You know, a lot of those lovely shots, and they really are just unbelievably beautiful mm-hmm. shots that you get in the movie, you know, they're taken from a couple of thousand feet in the air, whereas we're at ground level. And usually when you're at ground level on the Appalachian Trail, you're enclosed in a tunnel of trees.
Yeah.
So your sense of the landscape around you is much more confined and muted.
And are you isolated?
Yeah, you are very much.
Are there many people on the trail, or?
There are, you know, sometimes you run into a couple of people and you tend to be walking along. You know, there may be 18 of you,
yeah.
but you're staying the same distance apart the whole time, so you may not know who's 3 miles behind you.
So we're talking miles there.
Or 3 miles ahead of you.
Yeah.
And only, you know, if for some reason you slow down for a reason, if, you know, one of you's twisted an ankle or something, then all these other people catch up with you and you begin to see them. But you tend to see the same people over and over again because you're all walking pretty much as a unit.
Right, okay. But, you know, one thing that struck me is that this is really like an off-the-road buddy movie, isn't it? And at any point, did you regret not doing the walk on your own?
No, I couldn't have done it without Katz. I mean, honestly, it was not my thinking when I did it, when he joined me, it was not my thinking that, oh, this will make the book.
Mm-hmm.
But when I reflect on it now, if it hadn't been for him, I wouldn't have had the companionship or the conversation or just the experience that would provide the material for a book.
I don't want to reach for metaphors, but...
No, reach, Bryson, reach.
Well, they say the Appalachian Trail's like life. You don't know what's ahead, you don't know what's going to happen next, but you give it your best shot.
Best.
So on that note, we go?
We go. All right.
Are we hiking or strolling?
What, is this a race?
You're trying to do 11 miles.
Slow and steady, pal. You want to burn out your legs? Go ahead.
Oh, it'd be nice to get there before midnight.
Yeah, well, that would be nice. Go ahead, help yourself.
Do you agree with Nick Nolte's portrayal of cats?
Perfect. It is, you know, genuinely, it is absolutely perfect. They physically, they're not all that similar, but in terms of the sort of spirit of it, he was perfect. He was absolutely perfect.
And I just thought, quite a character.
I think, you know, I think he deserves a lot more credit than I suspect he'll be getting in reviews, because what he had to do was he has to start off playing this extremely exasperating, rather unlikable character, and then you have to warm to him, as happened in real life. And you know, Robert Redford character, me on the screen, has to become pretty dependent on him, at least emotionally. And that's a very subtle transformation, and Nick Nolte, I thought, pulled it off brilliantly.
He was extraordinary. So tell me, what was worse on your adventure? Your encounter with the bears or your encounter with Mary Ellen?
With Mary Ellen, I'm afraid. Because the bears was a very fleeting thing. It just happened, you know, it was for a half an hour or something, and then they shuffled off into the undergrowth, and we weren't bothered anymore. Whereas Mary Ellen went on for two very long days.
Okay.
And she was,
that was hard.
She was genuinely, as she's depicted in the book, which is just a piece of work.
Hard, I mean,
she really was hard work.
Yeah, oh, that's very funny.
Cats. What was that?
How the hell should I know?
It sounded big.
Everything sounds big in the woods, Bryson. It's probably just a skunk. Or dead.
Did you pack a knife?
No.
Nothing sharp?
Nail clippers.
Oh, swell.
Leave it alone, Bryson. It'll go away.
Oh, yeah. Well, if it is a bear and it comes towards you, what are you going to do? Give it a pedicure? Jesus! Two bears staring right at me.
Oh, God damn it, Bryson. Get some sleep!
If they come for us, play dead.
If they come for us, we are dead.
What is your most enduring memory of your adventure? And did the film cloud that in any way? Did it change your memories in any way?
No, what the film did do was it brought back to me, it really did quite vividly brought back to me certain of the things we did. Mm-hmm. There's one scene, when I came into the screening last night, at the very end where there's a sort of assortment of shots of the trail looking very, very beautiful. Uh-huh. And there's a couple of places where I actually remember being in that very, very spot.
Okay.
And seeing that in such kind of rich technicolor light and everything brought it back to me.
Fantastic.
Made me almost want to go and do it again.
Oh, no, good for you. My final question, were any liberties taken that have caused you embarrassment or regret?
No, there were many liberties taken, some of which slightly mystify me. Just for instance, my wife's real name is Cynthia. In the movie, she suddenly became Catherine.
Uh-huh.
I don't know why they did that. It's harmless. It didn't make any difference. It doesn't matter to anybody. But why they did it, I don't know. But there were lots of little things like that all through the book, but all through the movie, but absolutely nothing that caused me any dismay at all. The only place where I started to get a little bit uneasy, because you have to remember I was sitting with my wife the first time I saw it, was where Robert Redford seems to be about to have some sort of a friendship with Mary Steenburgen.
Oh, yes.
And I did really want to lean to my wife and say to her, this never happened, and it's not even in the book. So
did she give you a look?
No, well, no, but I could kind of feel her tightening slightly, because you know, you don't know where this is going if you haven't seen the movie.
Yeah.
But it's all remains very chaste, and I think it demonstrated that Robert Redford and Bill Bryson together are men of great virtue, and we both behaved ourselves on the Appalachian Trail.
It's a brilliant movie. Thank you so much.
Thank
Bill.
You. Thank you very much.
Thank you for being here. It really means a lot.
It's our pleasure. I mean, it's not a pleasant time.
No, we're just very sorry.
We're very sorry.
I'm tired of life being all about ailments and funerals. I want to push myself.
You want to hike the Appalachian Trail?
2,000 miles. You have gone mad.
It's my old pup tent.
It's the perfect place for you to spend the night. 2,000 people a year try to do this. Less than 10% make it. Fit people in their 20s can't do it, Dad.
You'll need a rain cover, too.
Rain cover? Why?
To keep out the rain.
You are not doing this alone.
How would you like to join me for a little stroll?
Not in this lifetime.
Next time, call me for something fun, like a colonoscopy.
Bryson, it's Katz.
Stephen?
Not Stephen Katz. You two ended up on each other's nerves in Europe.
That was 40 years ago.
I gotta eat every hour, otherwise I get these,
Seizures?
Seizures, that's right.
Good luck.
Try not to die, okay?
We go?
We go.
What goes up must come down. What the hell happened to Dom?
John Muir once said, sometimes a man just has to get a loaf of bread and throw it into a sack and jump over the back fence.
You okay?
Never better!
You guys camping here?
No, we live here.
How can I help you?
You like a cabin?
You know what your problem is? You're too fat.
We're not even halfway there.
No way that's to scale.
Map to scale. That's it. New plan.
You want to drive the Appalachian Trail?
I came out of here to be with you. One last adventure before it's too late.
You can do whatever you want, but this is my adventure.
Fine!
That's the spirit.
Kathy seems right, but one woman all these years?
Well,
that can't be good for you. There is a sun
to shine. You know, I'm sorry we lost touch.
Yeah, me too.
Jesus, if they come for us, play dead.
If theirs, if they come for us, we are dead.
Well, they say the Appalachian Trail's like life. You don't know what's gonna happen next, but you give it your best shot.